Welcome to an experimental video. Got some time on my hands, so this is the one I was fooling around with in my last video. This is a random video, but small problem. None of these discs I have right here for my hands have any labels on them, so I'm going to fix that. How do you do that? You use one of these. By bringing a disc, I'll be able to easily make a label for it. So, turn that on. See what this disc has on it. There's no real point to this video, it's just time waster. Okay, this is Star Trek 2 and 3 soundtrack, so what medium works like. Little big. Okay, sorry, I didn't mean to name for this. Problem is, any cut into what I have is my nail clippers. So, it's nice little scalloped edge, nice. This disc is a bit weird looking. I love the way it looks, so rather than making the front look weird, I'm gonna make the back look labeled. This is not going to be perfect in any way, but you know what? It's going to be a fun trip getting there. Just goes in that way. Pipe it up like this. This one I'll always know where it is because it's the only Maxell one I have. Why am I ruining that? Alright, so that's how clear works. Alright. Learning. Excited. Steve making a random video. I got 11 minutes on recording, so. So this is ELO. ELO. Greatest hits. Remember, if you're the only one using it, it doesn't have to be pretty, it has to be able to organize. sorter name. I'd be asking, why am I not doing clear? Because I don't have white. So this, you know, simple organization. That's all I'm doing. This is clean from that. See what it is. Ah, Bowie. I know he's a big star, but that's a bit big. I just have size. Print. That's even good for the freaking yeah. Yeah, that's actually good enough. It's good enough. Just queen. Yep. I gotta go through and edit the title. Actually, I'm just okay if that one's being clean. I don't plan to have another queen disc. Not that I'm not a fan, a big fan, it's just I got all the ones I need on one disc. What do you really need? Yeah, that's good enough. I go back and fix that later, but yeah, that works. Hooked on Classics. So I have that. I do, so. Label up. I have it. 5 minutes to go. On this recording. I might have to split this recording and do two. So, as Stuart Asser would say, expect a zone cut. I don't think he ever said that, but yeah, there's gonna be some cut in a few moments. So, if things change subtly between shots, I do apologize, but it's the nature of the equipment. That's adequate. A little bit of cleanup happened. This is Huey Lewis, and this is put that one. 80s pop. No, sorry, it's S-Y-N-T-H. Last P-O-P. That kind of describes what it is. It's pop and synth. In the order and it's actually on the disc. That's a good idea to do. These are the newer style discs. So I have a little bit different. I do like keeping as much of that exposed, but I think if I turn this down enough. Now you may wonder now, why is Stevie's in nail clippers? Why does he have any scissors? I'm actually in a hotel room right now. Fun fact, I am kind of self-quarantined from my family. My grandparents, so... another thing. So when I'm done with work, where I drive a truck, I get off on the weekends right now, and therefore, boom, I go to a hotel room. And slide on the case, there we go. Not what's on there anymore. So carefully. Okay, I'm right here. I'll clean this up later. Or now. We got time. I don't have my lens wipes to clean it with. They're alcohol based. I'll just cut right through it. Can I put on this one? Because I know I erased this one. Okay, this is actually a blank one. So, edit, okay, erase, okay, protected. Okay, that's right, protected from here. Yeah, what happened was, I tried erasing it in Sonic Stage. Oh, okay, sorry, okay, this actually isn't erased. This is actually a pretty good Star Trek soundtrack. It's the Philharmonic Orchestra doing all of the Star Trek music that I like. That's a good way of putting it. Yeah, sorry, I had a disc earlier that was having issues being recorded upon. That's good enough. Just me. This is driving you crazy. I'm sorry. I am not a perfectionist when it comes to labeling stuff. Label gone on this one too. This one, yeah, I had a couple where I came with labels and I used them until they fell off. Some fell off. Electric Dream soundtrack. That's a good soundtrack. Very underrated movie. Directed by the guy who did Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Steve Barron. Written by Rusty Lemonade, starring Lenny Van Dolhen as Miles, and Virginia Madsen as his neighbor. I forget her name right now. I do remember the computer's name, Edgar. So if you're wondering, has Steve ever seen that movie? Yes, I have. Virgin Pictures released it. It's very hard to get a hold of the United States. I actually got it from my mom. She saw I like movies about computers and stuff like Short Circuit, and she found this movie at I think Blockbuster. No, it wasn't Blockbuster. It was West Coast Video, because Blockbuster came around later in my area. Found two discs. I wonder if I can guess what's on this one. I wonder what's in my wonder wall, right? Isn't that what that used to go by? Supergramp. Yeah, that's Supergramp Breakfast in America. SUPERFASTINA. Print. Print. Because it's an actual album, I'm actually printing the full thing out. Then I'm going to trim it around the letter P. Careful. And yeah, that one's a little tight. Please direct all comments on how I am being horrible with these labels to nobody, because it's my mini discs. I'm gonna label them like I want. You're asking, why is he not using the entire label area? I like the design. I like keeping as much of it open as I can. I like showing off the technology itself. I debate how I want to label it, because I do like that little section right there. But as I committed to properly labeling it with the album name, because this isn't a greatest hits album, it's an actual album, and required at SP speed, by the way. Yes, there's actually ways of doing that now, where you get the full high quality experience for a MiniDisc, which isn't the easiest thing in the world to get for the people. If I'm doing that. It's a weird album anyway, I mean. Yeah, that looks fine. Maybe they just do that. Orange. I forget what's on this. Madness. Divine Madness. Actually, the very best of Madness. One step beyond. Yep. And this one, I can actually clear. MADNESS. See, I got another math album I need to rip later. That's a two disc album though, the one I want to rip later. It's only a single disc album. There's a lot of wonderings going on, but I am wondering if anybody's going to ask, why do you label your mini discs? Well then, if you're asking that while you're watching the beginning of the video, the answer is here. I use these while I work in the truck. I like the novelty, I like the sound they give off. The DAC in this player is actually pretty good. Pretty good DAC, really good for the audio system. And also, if I want to find more songs, I just add disc, look at what's on them, and bada bing, bada boom, I have different mini discs. I really love the way this one looks. Front and back and brain color. Special bonus. Well, I got a couple minutes to show you guys. I actually own a pre-recorded album now. So we're going to test it. 13 tracks. Sounds pretty good. I was afraid it would sound like crap. Because I've been told that the early A-track was a bit more overzealous with its compressing. Yeah. Well, thank you for coming. I don't know what you guys want to watch this channel for. So I'm just, you know, making content for the sake of making content. Everybody, well, stay healthy, stay socially isolated. That's day in this April time frame. And this is going to be up, well, whatever. Be healthy. Bye.